Good morning children, I am Kriti Kumar. Welcome to the online computer class. Today I am going to start chapter 9 using list, images and links. In the previous class you were introduced to the basic formatting tags used for designing web pages in HTML. In this chapter we will discuss some more tags that are used to embed objects like list, link and images in our web page to make it more appealing and professional. Let us see the first one, list. Whether it is the minutes of a meeting, a list of ingredients in a recipe or the table of contents of a document, you will find the use of a list in all of them. A list is the most efficient way of presenting information in a precise manner. It helps in making important points stand out more clearly and thus grabs a visitor's attention. HTML supports different elements that are used to create a list for displaying items in a specific order. The types of lists that HTML provides are unordered list, ordered list, definition list. Unordered list. The unordered list is used when the items are not to be displayed in any particular order. The list can be defined within the UL and closing UL tag. Indents. Each item in the list and add a bullet against each of them. That is why unordered list is also known as bulleted list. LI tag. You can display the listed items in an ordered and unordered list by using the LI tag. By default, the list items are preceded with the solid circle, which can be changed using the type attribute. The type attribute we use with UL tag. It is optional to use the closing tag in LI. The type attribute. The type attribute specifies the type of numbering and bullet used to mark items in an ordered and unordered list respectively. By default, its value is 1 for and an unordered and disk for an unordered list. Let us see the table. The type attribute, if you use disk attribute, then this picture, solid circle, by default it will come. If you use circle, then a non-solid circle will come. If you use a square, a solid square will appear in your list. Let us see the example. See children, I have typed a coding here for making a list. Now, as you know, we always start with the first tag HTML. So, I have written HTML. Then head, then I have given the title inserting list, open title, close title, within that inserting list, then head should be closed, then body will begin, and body I have given here the attribute bg color and its value green, so the page will appear in green color. Then I want my heading in bold and its font size in 7 and color in yellow. So font size, the attribute is size and value is 7, then attribute is color and size value is yellow. 5 D's for success, this is the heading, and then font I have closed and bold also I have closed here. Then now I want to make a list. So for starting a list, unordered list, what you have to take UL tag. UL, unordered list. Then you have to close this and come to the LI, because LI gives you a listed item. So LI tag, then I have written dedication, LI devotion, LI discipline, LI discrimination, LI determination. Now I want to close my list, so I have to type here closing LI. Children, if you want, you can type LI after every listed item, but it is optional. If you don't want to write, but in the beginning you have to write, and in each, before the each item where what you want to print, in front of that you have to write LI, but in the end you can use closing LI tag. Then my list is over, so I have typed closing UL tag, close the body, and then close the HTML. So this way, I hope all of you understand UL tag, then LI. Let us see the result. So now I will save it. Already I have saved it as a save as, but again I'll save and minimize my window. Go and see the result. So this is the result, this is the output. 5 D's, green, BG color, green, then heading bold and in yellow, and font size 7, and these are, this is the list: dedication, devotion, discipline, discrimination and determination. Let us go back. Now you see these words are coming in little small font size. So what I can do, I'll just cut this font here from here and paste it before UL. So this way you will see our result will be in different form. See, so this way you can see the solid circle by default. If you are not typing any type attribute, then also by default, whatever the list, it will appear in the solid disk. This is called solid disk. Okay, now let us see the attribute of UL tag. So the attribute of UL tag is type, T-Y-P-E, type, then equal, I'll give its value circle. So circle will show the result, hollow circle. So now I will say save, minimize it, open it, and you see this is replaced by circle. So this is the work of type attribute circle. Okay, next we'll try another attribute, that is type, and it's another value square. Let's see the result. First you have to save, then minimize, open it, and you see the circle is replaced by square. So this is the result of your output. Now we'll go back here, and you see by default, if you are not typing a type attribute, then automatically it will come as a disk. But if you want to change in square and circle, then you have to use type attribute and the value what you want, a square or you want a circle. If I type here disk, so what will happen? Let me save first. So you see, it is here again, you can see disk. So this is the three values which you can use with the type attribute. So UL tag, and you see because it is an attribute, it should be after UL. If you close here, close this UL with this, then this will not work. So closing tag will come at the back. The cascading bracket you have to put in the after disk. So this, I hope children, all of you understand. So you please copy this coding in your notebook and try if you have a computer at your home. Thank you.